All right, guys, we're in a four-year-old stand of perennial clover and alfalfa, and it looks amazing. And here's the secret to making this plot continue to look great now and in the future. This is a perennial plot, red clover, white clover, and alfalfa, and a little bit of chicory mixed in here. It is year four or five from its initial seeding, and kind of some of the things that we've been using to make this plot look as good as it does is continuing to overseed thin areas by frost seeding in that February-March time frame. That's happened once or twice. But one of the other secrets, as this stand continues to get older, that is happening, let's say, within the soil, is that these legumes, the alfalfa red clover and white clover, is producing its own nitrogen. So we have a buildup of nitrogen into this plot with them being legumes. So what we're doing, instead of just having weeds take in that excess nitrogen, in the fall time frame, we're advising and recommending the client come in and drill wheat or oats, preferably oats, into this stand to take in some of that excess nitrogen that's being produced. And what that does is limit some of the weeds, but also extends the life of this clover plot or perennial plot well into the winter time frame. So this is going to go dormant here in Southeast Ohio, that mid to late November, early December time frame. But when you have oats drilled in here, those are actually rocking during that period. So this plot never really sees a dull time frame unless it's under snow cover or just super dense, hard winter, that late January, February time frame. So we have a very small window now in which this plot is not offering forage. And then coming back into the spring, clover, alfalfa, everything livens back up. The oats take back off, and now we're looking at a wonderful stand. There's always a little bit of other maintenance techniques that may need to be done. We've got a little bit of grass that wants to creep back in here, but it's still a very small percentage at this stage in the game that many other plots have problems with 4, 5, 6 years into their planting. So still looking really good. Of course, always recommending every 2, 3 years to take that soil sample as well. If we're deficient in phosphorus, potassium, anything like that, we want to make sure we're doing that and adding those amendments. So make sure you're checking, monitoring everything, but consider the legume, consider planting the oats, extend the life of it, and manage weeds. And you too can have successful plots like this. This is late May, early June, and we have zero shortage of forage in here and a wonderful, wonderful stand. These oats are going to die out, mature out, and continue to help shade this plot throughout the rest of summer. So a lot of great things happening here. Hopefully that helps you manage your clover and perennial plots now in the future. Let us know in the comments below if you've used this technique and what you think about it and how it may help you in your food plot struggles. All right, now some of you guys may be wondering, man, what are those oats gonna do? What happens if they reseed themselves? That's not really a huge concern, it's added forage, but you gotta think about broadcasting into a very heavy base of a perennial crop. That's not really going to be a great combination for successful germination of these seeds. So if you are concerned about that, you can easily mow and clip off the oats themselves. And some other people might be worrying about, well, aren't the oats taking away from the actual planting? Well, you can see within the planting of oats where it's seeded at and had been drilled, there's no shortage of alfalfa and red clover and some chicory and white clover. They're working together. So we have an annual drilled into a perennial. We're not really worried about what the future of the oat may be. Worst case scenario, some germinates, it's added food back into the plot itself. So in this particular instance though, there are a couple areas where there are some grasses that have popped up in this plot. So we are going to clip this one, clip the heads off of those grasses. We want to come back and spray with a clethodim. And so between clipping the oats and our clethodim application to get rid of the other grass small pockets, the oats aren't gonna make it. So regardless, they've served their purpose and there's lots of ways to manage beyond it. If you see it and you don't like the look of it, you can manage around it, but it served its purpose and it's a wonderful addition. We certainly would recommend later stages of alfalfa plots or perennial plots, consider adding and drilling in oats.